Now I will explain LED TV and LCD TV also same. Before going that lesson one, now I will explain how to stop any motherboard. That means laptop, desktop or LCD TV, LED TV, plasma TV. So in here three chips will come. That is CPU, ROM and RAM. When you give CPU, supply reset clock signal. So in LED TV, 3.3 volts and 1.2 volts supply. This supply will change depend on CPU. You will see supply reset clock signal from crystal. After this IC will start function, CZ or CS signal goes to ROM IC. This is SPI ROM. After SDO, SDI signals and SCK signal comes to here. You will check this signals through CRO. I will show in practical lesson. After pressing power button, RAM, RAS and CAS W signal goes to RAM. So in here, RAM supply will change depend on RAM. So in different types of RAM is there. That is DDR1 means 2.5 volts, DDR2 1.8 volts, DDR3 1.5 volts, DDR3 1.35 volts, DDR4 1.2 volts. So you will see RAM supply means including RAM supply means you will see in this way only. So in his fixed 3.3 volts in here. Now I will show in circuit diagram also three chips will come. See in this motherboard, this is CPU, this is ROM, this is RAM. This wants supply 3.3 volt supply. This wants 3.3 volts and 1.2 volts. This one depend on RAM. In TCON board also same. Now I will show that also. This is TCON board. This is TCON board. This is main IC. This is ROM and RAM. Now you will see another board. In here, see here. This is ROM. This is main IC. There is no RAM chip. But that is included inside. So this chip have one pin DDR supply. I will show in circuit. So there is no RAM, but that is included inside. Already this chip have RAM chip also. So one pin has RAM supply also. In the latest all models, main IC have RAM. In here also another circuit, this one also same. This is main IC included inside RAM. This is SPI ROM. So two chips will come in latest models. Now I will explain this diagram. How to start a LED TV? Now I will explain. See here, LCD LED TV power start from adapter 19 volts or from SMPS 5 volts comes to 3.3 volts regulator. After that goes to main IC. 3.3 volts goes to 1.2 volts regulator. After that goes to main IC. So main IC without pressing power button, 2 volts comes to main IC, that is 3.3 volts and 1.2 volts. Now this is step 1. Now I will show in some circuits. You will see in here step 1 always voltage. I given so many circuits in here. I give this videos. Now I will explain this circuit. This is block diagram. So in here from adapter voltage goes to. Now I will show this. In here this is the DC jack. From this DC jack goes to, this is 3.3 volts regulator. After this goes to, this is 1.2 regulators. This 3.3 volts and 1.2 volts goes to this main chip and bias chip also. That means SPI ROM. In here EEPROM is there, that's why that goes to these two places. So in here any circuit, 19 volts from adapter or SMPS voltage goes to 3.3 volts regulator and 1.2 volts regulator. That voltage goes to main IC. 3.3 volts goes to SPI ROM, EEPROM is there, that voltage goes to that place also. Now I will show in such scene here, from adapter 19 volts goes to MP1584, standby 3.5 volts, that goes to pin number 7762 54. So now I will show in circuit. You will see in this way first block diagram, after you will understand only power supply or any, you will see first block diagram. This is block diagram, 19 volts goes to MP1584. Now we will see that IC. See here, JK100, JK700, JK700. That goes to pin number VIN, pin number 7. VIN, pin number 7. So when you give VIN, immediately V out are switching voltage, SW. This voltage come out from this IC, but in here enable pin is there. That's why if you any IC enable pin is there, after giving enable voltage, output will come only. There is no enable pin. When you give V input, immediately output will come. So we given V in pin number 7 through 100k resistor, enable voltage comes to pin number 2. After this switching voltage come out from this place, already this IC MP 1584. So this is L702. This IC 701. So after feedback will come to here. Any difference is there, voltage in output voltage, any difference is there, this will correct. After output will come exact voltage. So now we will see this circuit IC 701, L702. You will check in here. This voltage goes to, see in here, this is 19 volts. This goes to this IC L702. This is L702. IC 701. This is 3.3 volts. So after this 3.3 volts come out from this line, this goes to, this is 3.3 volts. This goes to this IC, IC 704. See here, 3.5 volts comes to here, IC 704. When you give input and enable, output will come out from this IC. This goes to, this is 1.26 volts regulator. So this is 1.26 volts regulator. This voltage goes to this main IC. After this goes to this IC 502 and 503 also. Now I will show that also. You will see main IC. See here, main IC. In here, 3.5 volts ST standby. You will see small coils will come in here. L502, 503, 504, 505. See here, L502. This is L502. After VDDC, 3.3 volts come out from this coil. You will see in this way. This coil is open, that voltage won't come to here. That's why in here, black color coils will come, or you will see LL. Nearby this main IC, you will understand, without circuit also. See, in here name is changed, VDDC, 3.3 volts. So that goes to main IC, VDDC. See here, VDDC 3.3 volts, VDDC 3.3 volts, that goes to in this way. Next, 1.2 volts also name changed. 1.2 volts VDDC, that name is changed VDDC. In here, VDDC 3.3 volts, in here VDDC, that is 1.26 volts. See here, VDDC, this goes to pin number 82, main voltage goes to 77. Next, so in here, see IC 502, this is IC 502. You will check pin number 1, this is pin number 1 dot. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You will see in here 3.3 volts is present means, or this voltage is present means, always 3.3 volts is okay. Same in here also, another IC, IC 503 pin number 8 supply. IC 503 pin number 8 supply. So first you will understand, any motherboard, not only this is LG, any motherboard, main IC wants 3.3 volts and 1.2 volts. In the LCD TV, after pressing that voltage will come, that is called core voltage. So in here, without pressing power button, 3.3 volts and 1.2 volts comes to here. And 3.3 volts comes to this. Now we will see assembling kit. Now universal board. Now I will explain universal board. In here, this is 5 volts regulator, input 12 volts, output will come 5 volts. That goes in here, 5 volts input, 3.3 volts output. That 3 volts comes to here, or 5 volts comes to here, output 1.2 volts will come. So without pressing power button, 3.3 volts and 1.2 volts come out from this regulator, that goes to main IC. Now I will show this. See in here, 12 volts comes to this IC, after output will come out from this coil, this output 5 volts standby. So this is 6-pin IC, 8-pin IC, output will come only 5 volts, standby voltage, standby 5 volts. This is 5 volts regulator. Now I will show in this board. From DC jack, this is diode, this goes to 12 volts supply to this regulator IC. This is in here 6-pin IC, in here 8-pin, that is changed. This is this coil, this one. You will see in here 5 volts will come. This is 5 volts supply. So if this 5 volts goes to, see here 5 volts standby, 3-pin IC, after 3.3 volts standby voltage will come out from this place. See here, this is 3-pin IC, input pin number 3, 1, 2, 3, pin number 3 input, 2 output, 3.3 volts come to this IC, that goes to this main IC and bias. Next in here, 5 volts comes to this IC, 5-pin IC, see here, this is 5 volts, from this coil 5 volts comes to here, U4, this also U4, this goes to this coil. You should check at this coil, 1.2 volts will come. See here, 1.2 volts. This voltage goes to this IC. So without pressing power button, this IC wants 3.3 volts and 1.2 volts. This IC 3.3 volts. In here, this is 12 volts, this is regulator, 5 volts regulator. After 5 volts will come to 1.2 regulators. Same 5 volts comes to 3.3 volts regulator. This is 1.2 volts regulator, this is 3.3 volts regulator. Without pressing power button, 3.3 volts comes to here, 1.2 volts also comes to here, 3.3 volts goes to this BIOS chip SPI ROM. Any motherboard, same procedure, I will show in some circuits. This is China circuit. Now I will show this China circuit. First you will see block diagram. Block diagram page number 28. See in here, standby 5 volts comes to here. LDO low drop out. After this goes to in here, see here 5 volts, but this is power on. After pressing power button. In here 3.3 volts will come. That voltage goes to directly this IC. In here weak core voltage after pressing power button it will come. So we want this IC. Now we will see IC number. G1084T43F. We will see this regulator. That is page number 29. Power supply page number 29. Next page. See in here. This is power supply from here. Pin number 12 and 13. Standby 5 volts. Come out from this place. This 5 volts goes to. This is panel voltage. After I will explain that. We will see in here. Standby 5 volts input. IC number G1084. So this is the 3.3 volts regulator. After 3.3 volts goes to main IC. This is main IC. See here 3.3 volts goes to this place. In here 3.3 volts name is changed in this way. You will see so many coils will come nearby main IC. You will check that coils voltage is present or not. You will understand. See here 3.3 volts supply, 3.3 volts supply. All these 3.3 volts name is changed in this way. You will see this supplies. Core voltage after pressing power button will come. In olden sets, after pressing core voltage will come. In later, core voltage means 1 volt or 1.1 volt or 1.2 volts. In latest model, core voltage 1.2 volts will come without pressing power button. Now I will show another circuit. Block diagram page number 32. Already I saw this way. That's why I am explaining immediately. This is the always voltage seen here from SMPS. This voltage comes to here. This is 5 volts regulator. After 3.3 volts comes to here. Always 3.3 volts. This goes to main IC. CN3701 connect. See here always 3.3 volts. Always 3.3 volts. Now we will see in circuit. Page number 30. See in here. This is SMPS. This voltage come out from this way. This is 24 volts input. 5 volts output. After this goes to 3.3 volts regulator. This is 3.3 volts regulator. 3 pins. Pin number 2 input. 3 output. 1 pin number 1 ground. See here always 3.3 volts. This goes to main IC. Now I will show that. This always voltage comes to here. See here. This voltage come out from this place. This goes to core voltage. That means 1.2 volts. In here 1.1 volt. See here always 3.3 volts. This comes to this IC 1.1 volt regulator. After this goes to standby core voltage VDD 10. That means 10 means 1.0 volt. 1 volt. Now we will see in here easy way. See here standby VDD 33. 33 means 3.3 volts. You will see inside you will understand standby voltage. We want standby voltage. In here also standby voltage. Standby. So this voltage also will come. See here, same voltage, same this regulator will go. Now I will see in here, this 3.3 volts comes to directly in this way, in here. After this 1.1 volt regulator, this goes to 1.1 volt regulator, that goes to weak core voltage. So main IC wants 3.3 volts and weak core voltage. Now I will show another circuit. Here, page number 42, you will see page number 42. See here, this is block diagram in here. They will give in this way, you will see VG way. See here. Standby 5 volts that goes to U701 3.3 volts regulator. After that goes to U703 1.1 volts standby. This goes to this IC main IC U401. So you will see this is very easy to understand. So see here U401 U402. That means this is main IC. In here 5 volts standby. This is 3.3 volts regulator U701. This is 1.1 volt U703. This two goes to U401. Now we will see power supply. Power supply page number 53. See in here power. See here this is standby 5 volts. This goes to see U701 3.3 volts regulator. After U703 1.1 volt standby voltage without pressing power button. This goes to main IC. U401. Now we will see that. U401 K means A, B, C, D. They will give in this way. See here U401. See here 3.3 volts standby voltage, 1.1 volt standby. So main IC wants 3.3 volts and 3.3 volts and 1.1 volt. Okay, I will go another circuit. This is power supply. Now we will see in here. This is standby 5 volts. See here standby 5 volts comes to here. Pin number 1 input. When 4 pins will or 5 pins will come, you will see enable pin. When you give VIN and enable pin, output will come only. There is no enable pin. When you give VIN, output will come out from this IC. This is 3.3 volt standby. Now we will see V-core. See here, V-core, core power, 12 volts input, enable 5 volts. When standby voltage will come, after this output will come. So in here, after pressing power button, this voltage will come. This voltage goes to main IC. This is main IC. This is power supply. You will see in this way, you will understand. The 3.3 volt standby, that goes to in this way. You will see standby, you will understand immediately. So this goes to main IC, only 3.3 volt. See in here, flash IC, bias chip. Pin number 8, supply 3.3 volt standby. So 3.3 volt goes to main IC and this IC. This bias. Now I will show another circuit, Hitachi 75 and 70 block diagram. You will see data purpose in their power supply. You will see another. The standby 5 volts goes to 3.3 volts standby. Now we will see. You will see these IC numbers. You will understand only. Now we will see in power supply number 91. This is power supply. Now we will see in here. See here 5 volts standby. 5 volts standby. After 3.3 volts standby voltage come out from this IC. This goes to standby 5 volts. After 1.2 volts coming in standby. So in here name is changed. See here 3.3 volts name VDDP. 1.26 volts means VDDC. So we will see VDDP, VDDC or AVDD also. VDDP means 3.3 volts standby. VDDC means 1.26 volts. This goes to main chip. Now we will see main chip 84. This is bias chip 3C here. Standby 3.3 volts goes to this place. 83 page number. See here VDDP, VDDC. So 1.2 volts and 3.3 volts. This voltage coming in here. This is main chip. U138 main chip. Now I will show another. Now JVC. Power supply 50. There is no block diagram. See here this voltage comes to here. 3 pin regulator. After this output voltage will come in here. Standby 5 volts or 3.3 volts. Go sheet number 3. Sheet number 3. Now we will see here 4 of 4. Total 4 sheets. This is 4. We want 3. In here 3. Standby 3.3 volts and 5 volts. Power 3.3 volts standby to this IC. 5 volts standby. This goes to this IC. After 3.3 volts standby. By voltage. This 3.3 volt standby voltage goes to MICOM IC. If MICOM IC is there, that voltage goes to MICOM IC and bias pin number 8. Now we will see another circuit. LG. LG MICOM IC. That's why first that voltage goes to MICOM IC. This is MICOM IC. Now we will see this MICOM IC 8101 or 8100. These two chips. Now we will see. That is page number. First we will see power supply 34. So first voltage goes to MICOM IC. After pressing power button, voltage goes to main IC. Main supply and core supply also. There is no MICOM IC. MICOM included inside of this IC. That's why we are seeing supply to supply and everything. We will start this IC first. But MICOM IC is there means you will start with MICOM IC. This is power supply. From power supply, 3.3 volt standby voltage come out from this power supply. This is power connector. After this goes to page number 35. This goes to MICOM IC. See here 8101. This is MICOM IC. So in this place, after pressing power button, supply goes to main IC. In here, this is MICOM IC. And EEPROM chip 8100. This voltage goes to pin number 8. Now we will see another circuit. Panasonic. Page number 34. Block. First you will see block diagram. You will understand. This is block diagram. See here MT3. 5385 power tree. That means this is main IC. Standby 5 volts. That goes to standby 3.3 volts. Power EN. After power EN, this voltage VCCK 1.2 volts come. Only 3.3 volts now. So U2IC. This is 3.3 volts regulator. 5 volts standby voltage goes to U2. After that output come out from this standby. This goes to main IC. You will see in here VCCK. After pressing power EN. After pressing power button, that voltage will go. Now you will see power supply page number. Page number 35. Next page. This is power supply standby. This goes to U2. This is U2. AX100. You will see black diagram. You will understand. AX100 U2. 3.3 volt. 5 volt standby voltage comes to here. After this regulator will come out from this place. 3.3 volt. This goes to main IC. This goes to so many places. But this goes to first main IC. Page number 36. 3.3 volt standby. See here. 3.3 volt standby. Name is changed in here. This goes to this place, standby, regulator standby. This is goes to so many pins. That's why you will see all pins. This standby voltage goes to this way. First, you should check this resistor. Any resistor is open. Now, you will see another. So, first, you will see where is 5 volts regulator and 3.3 volts regulator and 1.2 volts regulator without pressing power button. That's why I am explaining in this way. Now, you will see Philips. Page number 17, block diagram. This is block diagram C, power supply flow. Standby voltage goes to U101, 3.3 volts come out from this. You will see only 3.3 volts. That goes to U102. Now we will see power supply. Page number 25. U102. You will see U102. Page number 25. This is power supply. See in here. This voltage 12 volts. This 12 volts comes to here. U2. This is standby 5 volts. This is given gate. After gate voltage, this output will come. After pressing, this will come only. 5 volts standby. This goes to page number 18. This is power supply. U102. We want U104. This is 5 volts, 3.3 volts. And 3.3 volts standby. U104. Name is changed. AMS11117. 3.3 volts regulator. This voltage goes to main. But name is changed. Same. AMS11117. Yes. AMS11117. 3.3 volts. This goes to main IC. Page number 19. Next page. This is main IC. See here. Name will change in here. You will see coil. This is standby 3.3 volts. AVDD 3.3. 33 means 3.3 volts. This comes to main IC. This is main IC. No, this comes to this pin. Next another Samsung. This side TV have microprocessor IC. That's why you will see microprocessor IC. 248. In here my com IC. So we will see power supply first. 246. This is power. Now we will see power. See in here. Always voltage 5 volts. This comes to here 5 volts. And 5 volts goes to this regulator. After 3.3 volts coming in here. This goes to main IC. That means my com IC. This is my com IC. This goes to main my com IC and this my com IC. Small my com IC. 3.3 volts comes to here to this pin. Now you will see another circuit. Sanyo. First you will see block diagram. Sanyo. Page number 38. See here block diagram they are given. First you will see power supply block diagram. You will understand. 5 volt standby voltage. This goes to this IC U12. After 1.1 volt standby voltage will come. This is STB cover power standby. Weak core voltage also in here. This is U10, 3.3 volts, U12, 1.1 volt. This is 3.3 volts standby. So now you will see in circuit power sub 39. Next page. See here 5 volt standby voltage. This is 5 volt standby U10. After 3.3 volts standby voltage coming in here. See here 3.3 volts, 5 volts standby. 3.3 volts standby enable will come. After 1.1 volt will come out from this stage U12. This is U10. See here U10 and U10. This 2 volts goes to main IC. Page number 47. This is main IC. See here 3.3 volts standby, 1.1 volt standby. You will see in last page U1 this IC. See here this also U1. A, B, C, D. This also U1. This also U1. See here U1, G. I will see in this way, last page, U1. You will see in here, power supply is coming. After you will understand, last page you will understand. This 3.3 volts and 1.1. Now I will see another circuit. Sharp, page number 70, power supply. This is power supply. This is adapter socket. This voltage goes to, in this way, 12 volt standby. This 12 volt standby goes to V in pin. See here, 12 volts goes to pin number 8, V in pin. Enable also 12 volts in standby through 10k resistor. This is direct. This is to 10k resistor. When you give V in and enable, after output will come out from this IC. See here, this voltage come out from 5 volts standby. So input to 12 volt supply, input 12 volt supply, output 5 volt supply. This goes to 3.3 volts regulator. See here, 5 volt standby input U21. This goes to 3.3 volts. After this IC, this voltage goes to main IC. 76. See here, 3.3 volts standby. This name is changed. AU33. 33 means 3.3 volts. The name is changed in this way. Standby name is changed in this way. After this voltage goes to this place. This is U4 IC. Main IC U4. And 71. Bias chip. See here, this is SPI flash room. Pin number 8 supply standby. See another time, page number 73, power supply. This is U21, 3.3 volts regulator. This is U9, 12 volts input, 5 volts output. U9 and U21. Now we will see this IC. Main IC U4, 19. They given diagram, you will see in here. See here U9, this is L3. You should check at this coil, 5 volts is present or not. This is input 12 volts, output 5 volts. See here U21, this is 3 pin 3. So, 12 volts comes to here from adapter, this IC. After L3 output will come 5 volts. That goes to this IC, U21, 3.3 volts. This goes to main IC, U4. This is U4. See in here, page number 73. See here, U21. This is 3.3 volts regulator. L3 coil. Now you will see L3. See here, L3 coil. U9, L3 coil. At 5 volts will come. You will see in this way, you will understand. Now, Sony. Page number 25. Block diagram. In here, they given power supply. 5 volts, 4 volts standby, that goes to in this way. Now I will show that from power supply. 3.3 volt, 4 volt standby voltage will come to here. See here, 4 volt standby input and output will come out from this IC, 3.3 volts. This is 3. This is RAM memory supply, 1.8 volts. This goes to main IC. This 3.3 volts goes to main IC. Page number 34. This is V core and this voltage 3.3 volts. 3.3 volts, 3.3 volts, ADC. This voltage goes to these places. So, first you will understand. Main chip wants 3.3 volts and 1.2 volts without pressing power button, and SPI ROM also same voltage 3.3. Next step, reset and clock signal lesson 2.